Welcome back to the show. With us now to talk about health and wellness is dietitian and fitness instructor Karen Ann Gaiman. Thanks so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
So it's not something you would think of when you think of wellness and fitness, but we're going to talk about ice cream. And please tell me why it's okay to eat it, please.
That's exactly the reason that I've come here. I know it's not, it's unusual, really. But if we do like sweets, there's no reason not to have them, even when we're dieting in order to lose weight. Because then if we don't eat it for a long period of time, when we decide that we're going to try some, we might eat just a lot more than usual. Exactly. Kind of binge on it. And it's proven in research. So I say let's have the ice cream, but we also have to keep it in proportion.
Okay.
So first thing we're going to do is learn about the different types of ice cream, what the stores have to offer us. So as you can see, just right here, we have the cream flavors that are normally higher on calories, about 250 to 280 calories in 100 milliliters. Also, these types of ice creams have fat, about 15 to 25 grams of fat, and a little protein as well because of the cream. So about 3 to 6 grams of protein. Also, it depends which store you go to. Yes, different ice cream places make them different ways. Then we have the sorbet, which you could write see here in the different colors. We have mango sorbet and we have raspberry sorbet. So these,
so
these don't have any protein or fat. They are lower on calories, about 90 to 140 calories per 100 milliliters. But here you really have to notice if they are made out of fruit or if they're colored, and that's what makes them. Yeah, artificial.
Yeah, because what's this, I mean, this whole rumor about sorbet that it's healthy and all, I mean, you really have to watch out for the sugar content there.
Exactly.
Because it could be worse for you than ice cream in some cases, couldn't it?
Exactly, because it's lower on calories, but then again, it might be more concentrated with sugar and sugar that is added, not only the sugar from the fruit. So with the sorbet, you really have to see where you get it from. And then we have an ice cream, which is kind of like in the middle. It's low fat and low sugar ice cream, but still it's not diet, which means that it has less calories, around 200 calories, lesser fat, and not added with artificial sugar.
So that sounds like the best of both worlds.
Actually, it is.
It does.
Yes, it depends who is the person that eats it. Now, after we've learned about the different types of ice cream, let's talk about mixing and matching. So when we go to the store, we normally want to taste many different kinds of flavors, and then we might have just a scoop of each one of them. So the correct thing to do and the better thing to do while trying to lose weight is actually to take one scoop divided into two different flavors.
Okay, so you don't go just all out overboard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because if you do want to keep your weight, if you decide that you just want to go overboard, then every once in a while, that's okay too.
Yeah.
But if you decide that you want to keep your diet and eat ice cream, that's the way to go. Also, you should try and look at the different ways in which you could have your ice cream. For example, if you take a small cone, it has about 40 calories in it, which is not that bad.
Yeah.
It's high on sugar, but still, if you want to indulge, you can. However, the larger cone has more than twice the calories than the small one.
Really?
Yes.
It doesn't look that much bigger.
It doesn't, but it is.
Ah.
And this way, you could actually have another scoop of ice cream.
Oh, that's not worth it. I mean, just have the ice cream and take it in a cup.
That's exactly what I say.
Yeah.
Also, I recommend always to mix the different types of ice creams. To take one which is really creamy and rich with chocolate and Oreo cookies like the one we have here. And then on the other side, have a sorbet
to
even it out.
So is this healthier then? It helps reduce the calorie intake, you think?
Yes. Also the calorie intake and also the sugar intake.
Okay.
Also, try to eat around fitness. For example, if you have sorbet before a run, so the sugar from the fruit and the sorbet will give you energy in order to do your run. And that's better than just having the ice cream that has also fat in it. So you could actually play it out with your fitness.
And also after a workout as well is probably a good time to indulge in calories.
Yeah, so after the workout, I would go for the one that's also high on fat and protein, just because it's a better timing to have it after you've already burned the calories out.
Yeah, so that's a really good advice. And what about black ice cream? What's going on?
Yes. So black ice cream is a huge worldwide trend, and now it's here
not
in Israel also.
Oh, it's in Israel now?
Yes, now it's in Israel also. So it's black because it's made out of charcoal that you get from burning the coconut shell and adding it to the ice cream. So the ice cream itself is made from coconut oil and coconut cream, and also some of basically the ashes of the coconut shell.
Which just gives the color. It doesn't really change the flavor,
No, it doesn't. I mean, I haven't tasted it yet, I have to say, but I've read bloggers that have. And they say that it's more of a vanilla taste, really, really mild taste of coconut. And some say that it does taste a little bit like chocolate, but I just don't buy it. I don't think that it can.
Yeah. And you did like a whole segment on coconut oil. So it's interesting that they choose to use it making ice cream. So then is this black ice cream healthier?
That's a great question, because the active chocolate that's inside is known in the medicine industry. So if a person has food poisoning, it's a great type of medicine to give in order to, yes, to take out all the poisonous chemicals that are in the body and not have them absorb. However, if a person is healthy and doesn't have any issues, eating too much of that chocolate could actually take out some very important ingredients that we want to keep in our bodies.
Okay. Yes. So just eating it in moderation.
Exactly.
Where can we find this? Is it in Tel Aviv, in the city, probably?
Yeah, so there's one place in Tel Aviv in the city, but I kind of think that it's going to grow and be in many more places. And also, I see abroad that you can put that chocolate in all kind of drinks and in coffee. So yes, you could taste them. It's really, really cool, but just choose to do it moderately.
Of course. Well, I think it's great advice, and it's good to be told that you can still enjoy yourself, not totally limit yourself, but like you said, in moderation. Karen, thanks so much for this today.
Thank you.
And staying with ice cream, Joe Biden. Yeah, he may be known best for being Vice President of the United States in the last administration, but many also know him as an avid ice cream enthusiast. Throughout his tenure, he was often spotted enjoying a scoop or two, and a Cornell University senior has decided he should get his own flavor. They have their own creamery and make their own ice cream. So based on his old-fashioned favorite, the vanilla-based flavor will be filled with chocolate chips. Students will enter name suggestions, which will be announced before graduation. I wonder if he'll make a special appearance to that ceremony. And it seems these days, smartphones can do just about anything, and that may be true now more than ever. Introducing the MoCase, an Italian-made device that brews espresso conveniently inside your smartphone case. It has coffee inserts that come in three different roasts, and all you have to do is open the app to start brewing. It also comes equipped with a collapsible cup, so you can enjoy your cup of joe anytime, anywhere. And staying on the topic, pop star Justin Bieber had a burst of energy recently after drinking some iced coffee and decided to share this gem with his Instagram followers.
I just drank an iced coffee.
I don't know. I guess when you're a celebrity with millions of dollars, you can do anything you want. Okay, coming up next, Natalie Lahav joins us in studio to tell us why Disney has ruined our love lives. Stay tuned.